everyone. Andy here. I just wanted to share a quick word with you, something I've been reading as I prepare to preach this coming Sunday. You know, as I'm following along this coronavirus thing, I keep hearing words like unprecedented and once in a lifetime. And I just so happened to be reading this morning in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, and I just want to share with you what I read. It says this. This is Paul writing to the church in Corinth, and he says, "But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise, and God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong, and God chose what is low and despised in the world, even things that are not, to bring to nothing things that are, so that no human might boast in the presence of God." You know, I was reflecting and thinking about what Paul was meaning when he wrote those words, and I was thinking, you know, Paul was reaching deep into Jewish history, and he was remembering some very important things. It was that at times in their history, when they were using words like unprecedented and once in a lifetime, God had a tendency to show up in those types of moments. I can imagine that Paul was thinking about when God decided to start his own nation of people, and he chose a 100-year-old man to do it. That was unprecedented, but God came through. I can imagine Paul thinking of this fortress that they called Jericho, the walls of Jericho, that there was no way anybody could possibly get through those walls. And God instructed them to throw a worship concert. And as they walked around, the unprecedented, the impossible things became true because of what God did in and through them. And I think ultimately what Paul was thinking of was Jesus, that the greatest evil, the greatest thing on the planet, sin, it wasn't conquered because a warrior king with a sword showed up. It was conquered by Jesus doing something that people considered foolish, going to the cross and dying. But God had the last laugh because in Jesus, all sin was forgiven when he rose on the third day. So I just want to encourage you today that whether you're watching this and this is day 3 of quarantine for you, maybe this doesn't air until it's week 3 or even month 2 or something crazy, that God can come through in unprecedented moments, that people are saying things like, this is impossible and this is once in a lifetime. Those are moments where God, the God that I know in the Word, flourishes and does the most amazing things. So I hope you're encouraged today and have a wonderful day.